Welcome everyone to my channel Rising VLSI and the video series of TCL PK scripting. In this session I am going to discuss the array in TCL. Array is the third data type in TCL and it is considered as most systematically arranged data type where each element is represented by index. No doubt in the previous case like string and list also do have the index for the particular element, but that is a system defined. But in this case user have their choice, they can represent the element by their on list, on index number. So arrange is the most systematic, and then there are two methods through which an array can initialize. First of all, we can define each element separately, or we can define each element and index together. So I will take one by one or all. Suppose first of all, if I'm going to declare a first method set, if I'm going to take lang, one of the name of the list, here each element, if I'm going to declare the each element, I need to take here the small braces, set lang 0, it represent index number 0 of array name is the lang and index number 0. Suppose I'm going to write a name TCL. Now set, if I'm going to change the name PK, index number 1. Now if I can update some more element on the index number 2. There's a one command PArray. PArray is a command which simply print all the element and their particular index. So PArray lang there, in this command dollar is not required. So it is going to provide this type of systematic order, language index number 0 TCL, language 1 index 1 TK, language 2 Java INV, where we have written randomly. Now is our second method is to writing either we can declare all together like array set name of the array. Now index number element, index element. In this way we need to follow this order, first index element, index element, and so on. Now if I'm going to take the one another same example of declaration, array or language 1, suppose if I take the language 1 to make the differentiation, curly braces 0, on the 0 I'm going to write c, 1 c plus, 2 I'm going to write the r. Okay, some random number I have taken or random name I have taken. Now array, we have to write array set, array set, array name. Now this array has been initialized on this given order, index element. Now if I take the command p array lang 1, it is going to print the similar output, but in this order, which type of output we have printed by first methodology, second methodology also print the same structure, index 1 element, index 2 element, and index 3 element. So in the so on, we can declare the array in any method. Array do provide feature after declaration. Suppose if I'm going to declare set, first of all declare, I'm going to declare a array set, I'm going to give certain name new, some random name, on the index number 0 I'm going to write some number like abc, index number 1 bcd, index number 2 efg, some random value I have taken. Now if I'm going to write p array new, it is going to print each element, but suppose after some while I want to add a new element into the existing array. So we can add simply, we can go for the first method, set new over which index number I want to add. Suppose I want to add index number 5, a new element tuv. Now it has been declared. Now I am going to now the print p array new. Now this new member must be added, this new member must be appended over the given index number. say this one mechanism, the after the declaration of array we can add some new member into the list. Then there was another command we are going to existing is unset. Suppose I want to remove some particular command, unset, like I want to remove the new two. Simply I can write unset new, suppose simply write new two. So now in this case what is going to happen, unset new two, it means new two has been initialized. Now if I am going to follow the same command p array new, this number will not be print because this has been deleted from the memory or uninitialized in the memory. So one methodology is either we can set the element or we can set unset the element. So now one unset new two, so one a particular element which index number should be given, that particular index will be deleted. Suppose if I want to unset complete array, if I want to unset complete array, now this complete array new has been deleted from the memory. Now if I am going to print p array, so now it declares a message, it isn't an array because it is not available for TCL interpret. Now let's see, there are certain command based on the array, similar to the string or list based command. Here we have the array based command. Now this array based command, like very first, array exists. This command declares, checks whether array is available or not. If array available, it returns 1, otherwise it returns 0. Okay. P array already I have seen, print each element of the array. Now let's try to understand this availability. Suppose if I am going to declare a array set new, suppose L A and G, now the 0 TCL for the 1 index number 1 PK, index number 2 I am going to write Java. Now this array has been declared, or array set language, okay, I have taken the different character. I need to take curly braces. Okay. Now this array has been declared. Now I want to check whether the array existing or not. Simply write here puts. Puts, it will display, open the command array. All the array based command will start with starting word character, letter is array. So starting word is array. Similar to the string, array exists. Array exists, give the array name LANG. If available, it returns the output as a 1. Another command is P array, already seen, array names. Array name, it returns the index, how many index are presented. Now, if I go into the puts, array names. Array names, it returns the index of the array. So how many index are presented, like 0, 1 and 2. Array get command, it is going to return the array index and array element in pair, but the returning order is not in sequence, just like a p array return in the sequence, but get command is return in random order. So p array get array name of the array is LANG, it is going to return 0, 1 and 2. So it is going to return into the pairwise, like index element. The another command is array size, it is going to represent total how many elements are present. So total is going to represent what is size of element is 3. So this is one of the mechanism how can we play with array and their commands. Now there are one array based declaration. If I want to take the how it can declare a one dimensional array or two dimensional array, for that particular, like if I'm going to matrix like structure where we have element, four element I have taken, one row, four column. So here each element, first of all I need to declare by the index 0 element 0, index 1 element, which means each element must be prefixed by the index. Similarly for the two dimensional, here we have taken the, like I have taken two row four column, two cross four matrix, where each element again declared by the particular, and how I declare a matrix. First of all, if I open the declare a command array set, if I take here the array set, give the name of the array, suppose if I take the new, now we are going to write the index. If I write the index number 0, we have elements. Suppose if I'm going to AB, index number 1 BC, index number 2 EF, and index number 3 GH. So now it is going to display the complete element like structure. Like first of all, it is a one dimensional array we have declared. Okay, so element index, element index. Another method to declare the two dimensional matrix array set, if I take new one here, I can take the structure. So if I want to make like index number 0 element AB, index number 1 element BC, index number 2 element CD, and index number 3 element EF. Okay, afterwards I'm going to make the same structure. So 4, suppose if I want to give some other element 5. So now in here only thing we need to know, every element must be presented by different index. Now at 7 I'm going to write the RG. Afterwards close the array. This is one of the mechanism we can represent matrix. So I have taken the 2 cross 4 matrix like structure. Now if I take the p array new 1, it is going to display the all the element into the list by their index order. Okay. Now it is not necessary we have to use the numeric format to represent the element. We can represent by either a alphabetical or alternative method, or alternatively, suppose if I am going to declare an array set. So what earlier I told, first of all we need to represent element, then index. Now I am going to tell us the first of all my element. I am taking the element is alphabetical, and here I am going to represent some random element. Now index here B. Now it is the some other element. Now index C, I am going to represent 4, 5. Now index name. So now 60, 60. Now in this case, remember here our order is same. So here A will be index, this will be element, index element, index element, this is the index, here we have the element. Now if I'm going to declare P array temp, now okay, spelling of array. Okay, now we see it's going to display, follow the same principle. First of all, temp index A, element index B, element and index and particular element. So we can follow any method, either index can be numeric or index can be the alphabetical or mixed type. So this was the all about your array and data type into the list. Thank you for the watching. In the next video I will discuss about the file processing and file availability into the TCL. Thank you everyone.